Linda Bartsch from the Bruce Company is here taking your plant and garden questions at 270-9933. Some houseplants here.
I did bring on some attractive houseplants. This first one is called zebra plant. I think you can understand why, with that cool striping on the leaves. And it does develop a pretty flower that is like the one, the pink one that you're starting to see next to it. It almost is similar to that bromeliad. But these are all tropicals, so yes, houseplants, you could have them outside during the summer. And this cooler weather that we're getting, they would still be fine. We aren't anywhere near frost yet,
right.
Thank goodness.
And it's September, what should we be doing outside?
Well, if you are interested in your lawns, and I understand while I was gone, we had a lot of rain.
Mm-hmm.
Everything's all looking nice and green. So if you haven't fertilized, fertilizing is a good thing to do at this time of the year. And if you have things like Creeping Charlie, that's gonna be a little bit later on, that you would put down weed control to take that out. Of your lawns.
And plants that are done flowering, they're like...
Oh, deadhead. I think that the roses, well, in September, a lot of times, if you like the rose hips, then leave the flowers, the spent flowers on, because then you'll get a decorative rose hip on some of the roses.
Like I have my Asian lilies, those you don't cut down.
Not yet. No, the leaves are still going to be replenishing that bulb, so let that on, and they still look very nice
at
this time of the year.
All right, let's go to the phones. We'll start with Richard in Baraboo. Hi, Richard.
Hi, Mark. Hi, Linda.
Hi.
My question is, this year we got the mold in our green peppers.
Oh, yes.
And we picked a few of the peppers and nothing to brag about on any of them. And we're on a 3-year rotation with our garden, and I'm about ready to pull the pepper plants for the season.
Mm-hmm.
And I was wondering, is there anything I can do this fall to possibly minimize the chances of us getting that mold back again next year?
And you're already doing the rotation and you're pulling the plants. That's the critical thing. Do you do any composting with them?
No, not really.
So you actually dispose of that, okay?
Right.
Because if you do compost, you have to make sure that you get it up to a high enough temperature to kill those diseases. I think that you're doing the critical things so that you avoid that. I think it was partly the kind of season that we had. It was very cool in the spring. And see, now I think people's tomatoes are finally ripening up because it's hot enough, and the peppers are liking the hotter weather also. But we had a nice summer for us, but maybe a little bit too cool for our gardens.
Yeah, the tomatoes are late.
Yes, they are.
All right, Gary in Madison. Hi, Gary.
Hi, yes. Hi. My question is it a good time to plant garlic, or should I wait till October to plant garlic?
I think it's a little bit later. I don't remember. I saw a lot of bulbs out at our store, but I don't think that we have the garlic in just yet. I'll check with Matt and get back to you on next Monday and let you know if we've got garlic available. I think that's a little bit later.
That's something you plant in the fall, though.
Yes.
All right, Debbie in Linden Station. Hi, Debbie.
Hi.
Hi.
My question is, I have a hibiscus bush in my yard, and a friend of mine wants to take a clipping of it.
Okay.
And put it in her yard. How would we do that?
And this is a woody hibiscus, correct? It's not one
yet.
That... Okay. A cutting on that, if they're done blooming, you could probably take a cutting at this point. I really should check, because there's different times of the year that are better, and I almost think it might be a dormant cutting on that. Well, now that's two questions
everybody
have for next Monday. Let me check on that.
Well, you're good at this, making people come back. All right, Judy in Verona. Hi, Judy.
Hi, how are you?
Good, how are you?
Good, I'm fine. I have a question for Linda about an avocado seed. I planted, or I stuck it in water, just on a spur of the moment thing, and now it's rooted like crazy, and it's got a sprout coming up. It's about 3.5 inches, and I don't know if I should leave it in the water or if I should put it in dirt.
If you want that long-term to be turned into a houseplant, put it in soil.
Okay.
Yay, I got an answer for one.
Just plain potting soil, right?
Plain potting soil would be good, yes.
Oh, okay, thanks.
All right.
Sure. Bye.
Bye. That's kind of fun to grow that kind of stuff. I had a grapefruit I did that with, and it turned into this big tree.
It does, and it's beautiful, shining leaves. And I had an avocado that I had for years. You don't ever get fruit, but...
Right,
it's a nice houseplant.
I didn't get any grapefruit either. All right, we are out of time. If you're on the line, stay there. Linda will talk to you off the air. We'll see you next week.
And
what do you have to bring back now?
I'm going to have to check on the hibiscus
garlic and
garlic.
See you next week. We'll be right back with the final check of your forecast.